Hello, I am Dr. Abdul Basit, consultant in reproductive medicine at Madras Medical Mission. Today we are going to see what IVF is and how it is done. So in a natural cycle, natural pregnancy, the sperm from the man travels in the uterus and into the fallopian tube. The egg is released from the ovary and it also enters the fallopian tube. Here in the fallopian tube, the sperm fuses with the egg and the embryo is formed. The baby at this stage is called the embryo. The embryo then moves into the uterus to grow into a normal pregnancy. In IVF, we bypass all these natural mechanisms, and when in a normal cycle only one egg is produced, in IVF we produce up to 10 to 15 eggs at the same time. Again, how a lady responds to IVF injections depends upon the egg producing capacity of the lady. So we start the injections from day 2 or day 3 of the period, and then the injections are given here for any time between 10 to 15 days. And we monitor the progression of the stimulation with the help of blood tests like LH, estradiol, HCG and progesterone, depending on the day of stimulation. And the follicular growth, that is the egg growth inside the abdomen, is checked with the help of a pelvic ultrasound. Also, it is good practice to freeze a sample of semen and keep before the day of egg collection, so that on the day, if the husband is not able to produce a sample, it would be easier for us to utilize the frozen sample. Once the eggs have grown to an appropriate size, we give something called as a trigger injection. The trigger injection is actually given 35 to 36 hours prior to the egg collection procedure. This trigger injection is given to stimulate the final maturation of the egg. So the egg collection is done under general anesthesia and it is a daycare procedure. The lady comes fasting in the morning, gets admitted, gets the procedure done, stays in the hospital for 3-4 hours and then leaves in the evening. She needs to come back for follow-up the next day for a scan and some blood tests if necessary, and then for 1 or 2 days the next following week. And once everything is normal and she starts bleeding, we can start the process for the embryo transfer. In some situations, we transfer the embryos in the same cycle immediately after the egg collection. So in those cycles, we transfer the embryos according to the stage, either on 4th day after the egg collection or on the 6th day after the egg collection. If not, if we plan not to transfer the embryos in the same cycle, then we freeze the embryos electively and then only warm the embryos when we are planning for the transfer in the subsequent cycles. In the subsequent cycles, when we are doing a frozen embryo replacement, you don't have to undergo the same procedure that you had undergone by doing the egg collection. You have to take oral tablets and maybe few injections for your endometrium to grow. And when your endometrium is grown properly, we start progesterone, and the day of starting progesterone is calculated as day 0. And then the embryos are transferred either on day 3 or on day 5 depending upon the stage of the embryos. The egg collection is again a procedure which is done under general anesthesia with the help of ultrasound, and it is done vaginally, so there are no cuts to the abdomen, and it is a relatively safe procedure with very few and very rare complications encountered. After the embryos are transferred, you need to continue medications and injections for another 15 days, after which the pregnancy test is done to see whether it is positive or negative. If you have any further doubts regarding IVF and embryo transfer, feel free to contact us at